are blessed to present one of these insightful lectures entitled The Life of Lord Mahavira, The Embodiment of Love, Part 1 of 5, on Between Master and Disciples, given in Chinese and English on July 20th, 2019, at the Newland Ashram, Taiwan, also known as Formosa.
Tomorrow, I'm not sure if I can come here, so I see you tonight. I think that it's better I speak English all the time. You know why? It's easier to translate into many languages, yeah? If I speak Chinese, then we have to consider whether or not we have enough Chinese speaking, but good in English, or good in Spanish, or good in German, good in Russian, good in Vietnamese, all of these, good in Thai, good in blah, 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 blah. Got that? Okay. 你们要听右面，OK，护法。 左面就是听指挥。 右面听，常听的话听右面 ，OK？ 不常听就放左面啊。这边大概没有什么命令，所以赶快换了。听右面比较好 ，OK？ 打电话什么的要听右面，懂啦。万一忘记了，I thought it's something important, but fix the balcony. Fix the screen door, dogs ate it, to be exactly like before, my dog, they ate everything, as long as I'm not there. Yeah, I just want to show that I'm very welcome. When I come back, there's no door. Open, welcome. They are big already, 2 years something, still eating stuff, eating my book, my umbrella, my telephone, my table, my chair, my documents, your documents, I mean. Sometimes I look at your document, I don't know what the guy looked like. The photo eaten. Lucky good love always protect my document. If you see the small guy, dog come eat document, he come and lay on it. Yeah, nobody can touch it. They respect him. So they will not come and dig under his stomach and get the photos out and eat them. I have given them tons of toys. Okay? Even paper, carton, for them to chew. No. No fun. Eat books. To be smarter or something. More intelligent. Huh? That's the point. Books have something written. Carton, boring, only brown color, nada, nothing there. And the table look nicer, you know, than a piece of wooden bone that I gave to them. The table look, you know, more interesting. So they like to take care of those things. If you have dogs, it's easier to be a renunciate. Your clothes will be less than before. Yeah? Your table don't need. Yeah. A book no need, you already enlightened. What for reading anything? All the Supreme Master Qinghai need to read book. Yeah, all of you don't need. All the books go to my home. And you just come nothing. Go home also have nothing. Very very simple life. No? Yeah. All the complication comes to Master. That's the best. Yeah? We live simple life, correct? Okay, today I will read you the story that last time I promised you. before I go on and on and on with my calendar and my dogs and my cats and whatever. Ah, this one maybe look more like color. This one looks so thick like I can't see anything anymore. Okay, right. Now, this story title, The Embodiment of Love. So the master, the Lord Mahavira, at that time an ascetic, left the bone and skeleton village called Astikgram and proceeded in the direction of Ashvetambikatal. Okay, forgive my Sanskrit or Hindi. But you understand, right? The reason I let you come here so that you can help me with Sanskrit and Hindi, okay? Now, he went on this trail to the other town. The trail to this town passed through a dense and desolate forest. When some shepherds, you know shepherds, they take care of the sheep, yeah? They take care of big herd of sheep. No, maybe to graze around them, around there, okay. So, when some shepherds saw Mahavira entering the forest, they shouted very loud, "Oh, monk, 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 stay put for a minute. This is a very dangerous trail. There is a black serpent with a venomous gaze on this trail. His hissing and gaze burn plants and trees." Have you seen one like that? Must be a very evil serpent, eh? "Even flying birds and standing humans drop dead." Oh, if you see one like that, please run. Run fast. Use a golf car or something, maybe faster than him. Because snake can also be very fast. "So please leave this trail and take a different route." The shepherds warned him not to go in there. But Mahavira heard this fear-filled call of the shepherds, and with a serene smile, he raised a hand as a gesture of assurance. I don't know how that assured you, but I can only do this, okay? Do this is politeness, yeah, to you. Do this is to share my whatever I have. And whatever you can take, okay? There's two different gestures. I do both to make sure that you know, to reassure you, whatever that you need to be reassured of. Now, he said, oh, he didn't say anything. He just used his hand to reassure them that it's going to be all right. And then he went with firm steps toward the snake hole, very near. All around, human and animal skeletons could be seen. What kind of snake that eats humans also? Must be huge, huh? Big and nasty. And when you see one, please don't try to be compassionate or friendly or come and touch him and say, "Oh, you're a good boy." Good boy. Or good girl, good snake, whatever, huh? And if he bites you, please use your mobile phone. Not to talk to him, call the doctor quick. You got that? Or run to your car or wherever, whatever possible to get help. Because a poisonous snake is not friendly. Even, you don't know, even some snakes are not poisonous, yeah? But if your skin is punctured, then please take care, okay? It's very hard for your skin to recover from any injury, especially when the skin are so young like mine. So all people can see is just animals and human skeletons, and skulls also. There was not a single green leaf as far as the eye can see. Wow, what place is that, huh? Close to the snake hole was a dilapidated temple. Mahavira stood in the shade of this temple and started his standing meditation, you know. When he stood, that means he stand to meditate. Yeah. I don't advise you to do that. I'm worried that you make a hole on my floor, okay? With your head. I'm not worried about you. In case you want to do standing meditation, I advise you to wear this helmet that people use. Motorcycle, boom, 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 boom. Yeah? Okay. Okay, I can fix the floor, but the head is difficult. I have tried 30-some years to fix your head. I fell. So, I don't think I can do that. After it's even clashed with my floor. Huh? So please do take care of my floor and your helmet. If only I can fix human's head, I will feel like I accomplished something. Never mind, you know. I'm old already. I don't think I can go and get a job anywhere. And when people are retired, they have a lot of time, so I just come read your bedtime story. Yeah, what else to do? Okay? Hoping that maybe a few words will stay in your head. Oh, he begin his standing meditation. Yeah? Even if you sit, I already feel worry about you. Not to talk about standing and so tall as you are. No, small like me, maybe okay, don't have a lot to fall, you know? But so tall like you, or like a Westerner, for example, there, South African, or Americans, or English, yeah? Who are you? England? Canadian even. They're very tall. If they fall, it's long, long distance to my floor. So please just sit. Or lay down, okay? On the shoulders of your neighbors. Or on the lap of your behind neighbor, okay? Safer that way, huh? Mm. Oh, it's nice to lay on somebody's lap and just snore the time away, huh? Here, nobody dare say anything to anybody. When Master is not there, especially, nobody is a boss. We all are boss. Just like I told one of my nearby people, I say, all my dogs are alpha, because that's what I think. Normally in a group, there's only one alpha dog, but except good love. All other dogs, the six dogs, all alpha. What mean alpha? Top dog, leader dog, yeah? But they all know, even though they don't respect each other's position that much, because they all think they are alpha, because I spoil them so much. Each one of them think they are my favorite. So they are alpha. Alpha is A. A means top. Except for good love. And for me. Everybody else not listen to anybody else. Because they are all top dog. But they are very respectful to good love. They worship him. They lay on the floor, they kneel, and they turn around, they do their dancing, all kind of ritual just to greet him whenever they see him. And he, on the contrary, care nothing about all their fuss, you know, just, leave me alone. These dogs, they are adopted by him, so that's that's the worst he can do to them. Yeah. He's no ordinary dog. Huh? He really, really protect me. He doesn't like my cave. He told me the cave is dripping wet. He told me, it's not a secure place for you, I mean, for me. I say, if I don't care, why you care? But he does care. Every time I bring him to my cave, I bring them to my cave. All the dogs are happy, happy, wagging tail and stay. He always goes to the door, waiting to go out. He wants to make sure I understood what his message was, you know, like, get out, don't stay here. Well, I see nothing wrong with the cave. Before, yes, the water ran all over, you know. But now, because they made the fake wood floor for me, so the water ran under, so I don't see much of it. Yeah, I don't see much of the water. But he's still worried. I don't know why this guy is so very, very picky. Yeah? It's not just this cave. Before, I didn't have any place yet. You know, I didn't know about the cave yet. I didn't see the cave. And then, so I stay in one of the small areas. It's about maybe 2 square meters, something like that. And all around, it's just glass. Remind me the story, okay? You know my calendar. My calendar is special, yeah. It doesn't have only 12 months. Where was I then? Okay, I live in a small room, okay? And when my dogs come, I also let them come in that room with me. Everybody okay except him. He don't like it. So I ask him, what's wrong? It's very clean and it have a roof and have some walls around it. And there are a lot of windows you can see. I like it. You know, you can see outside. He says it's not safe. Yeah. Anybody can see you. That's what he said. Even protect my privacy. And I say it's okay for now, actually. You know, when the heart is big, it doesn't matter how small the place is. I didn't mind. This guy, he always picky, you know. He didn't like me to stay in small house, in small room, a small cave, or anything small, or anything that doesn't seem to have enough privacy, or easy to break in. You don't know him. Because of him, he helped me in England. So I became British also. It's not just now. He come and go all the time. He was a man, okay, in England. He helped me to arrange everything. And then he died young so that he can reincarnate again quickly wherever I am in a form of easier to access, like animals, dogs, geese. And his last life was a lady, you know, the dog named Lady. The lady, a dog that always leave her leg when she want to to do her business. Yeah, he does the same now. But he's a boy, so of course he does that. But sometimes he sit down, you know, and I bend down to pee like a lady too. So I don't know, who are you? You're a lady or a boy or a girl? He don't care. He's very serious, you know. He never smile, and when he smile, it looks scary. Because his teeth are big, his mouth so wide, and teeth are gleaming, you know. Because we brush teeth every day, all the dogs, you know. So he's gleaming, you know, and when he smiles, oh my God. I say, it's better you don't. He hardly smiles because he say he don't stop at that because he say he's a guard dog. Yeah, he has to be serious like that. I say, I have a little affection, man. It's too much to look at your face every day and your body so stiff and always on edge, you know. I'm tired. Do something, you know. Come and I lick my toe like other dog. He don't do such thing. He say, I don't do such thing. Oh, but my hand, no. Cannot show too much affection, he said. He has to concentrate, yeah. He's a funny guy. Lucky I have all the six dogs to smile for me and lick my hand and stuff, and my face. He's so serious, you know. Oh, he look like, something scary. You didn't remind me about my story. I remind myself this time. So he started his meditation, our Lord Mahavira. And then what happened? You know what happened, right? No? So easy to guess. The serpent came back. Who else is there? The black giant serpent came out of its hole, hissing fiercely. It has not seen a human being in a long time. The man was standing firm and fearless with closed eyes. Oh, he didn't like that. The serpent never saw such a man like that. The serpent was very surprised. Yeah. It looks at Mahavira with its venomous eyes. Normally, a snake has venomous tongue and fang, yeah, and a mouth and a throat inside where the venom comes from, right? But this guy, his venom came also through the eyes. There must be some very special demon, demonic serpent. Yes, the demon, they are not always invisible, eh? They don't always have fang long like this and the hair, you know, or big red eyes or hairy body, thing like that. They sometimes take a form of human. And if they have enough merit, somehow, then they can stay in human form for a long time. And you could never tell between a real human or a demonic one, yeah? And you also could not tell between a real animal and a demonic one, such as this one. So it's better you don't look into animal's eyes and the human's eyes if you're not sure, okay? Look into the third eye of every being, huh? That will bless them and keep you also safe from their influence. You don't have to hate any person, any being, even a demonic one. But you just have to also protect yourself. You can forgive a tiger or a snake for biting you, but please don't come and say, I forgive you, touch his head and say, I forgive you, or bring him home to show that you're really tolerant and have a good heart. You have to combine love and wisdom. Capito?
Yes.
Capish? Yeah, yeah. Love doesn't mean you always have to live with enemy, if you can avoid. Love doesn't mean you have to go deep into the jungle, into the den of the tiger, and go there and tell him, I love you. I truly love you. I come all this way to show you my love. Okay? Please don't, huh? Don't be silly. Tiger, they don't take the five precepts, okay? They don't know what ahimsa mean in Sanskrit or in Hindi, yeah. So don't blame me. Say, Master, teach us to love all beings. If you try to love the tiger this way, then please recite the five names, the gift, before you go in the den. And be ready to go up to heaven. If that's what you want, that's your freedom of choice. I will not stop you, but please tell your parents and everybody goodbye first, okay, before you go and find the tiger. Now, like flames from a ball of fire, its poisonous eyes emitted waves of venom. It hisses awesomely. But all this had no effect whatsoever on Mahavira. Please don't copy him. He is protected by all heavens and goddesses, yeah, at that time. Even though he doesn't require their assistance, but they always keep an eye on him because he is so pure and so determined to be enlightened, to help other beings. So when the Buddha was sitting alone under the Bodhi tree, he wasn't alone. You can see all the heavenly beings would be around him, but invisibly. Because, I tell you why. 1 second, okay? I put it there so I won't forget. Too long. Ah, perfect size. Because often the highly enlightened being, or not yet enlightened, but will be highly enlightened, they will not require mostly any help of any heavenly or physical beings. And even like one time one of the practitioners sitting in meditation, or maybe the Buddha, I don't remember who, the god Chakra appeared before him. And the practitioner tell him, oh, yeah, what business you do here? I said, oh, I just come to say hello, pay respect. I said, okay, good, now you can leave. He said, no, how come? Yes, you don't welcome me, I am the god. Many beings would be happy to see me. He said, yeah, but you obstruct my concentration and my vision. Yes. So, in many cases of the very important enlightened beings, when they're meditating, even though they are still not yet in a higher level, all the heavenly beings, many, you know, they will take turns to come and take care of him in case of some very serious problem. But they cannot interfere without the permission of that enlightened being, whether or not he has already become Buddha or not. Therefore, they are invisible, okay? They hide themselves within the wind, within the sun rays, so nobody can see them. My Hufa, my protectors, are also like that. I have also normal protectors, but I have protectors also from your school. Yeah, they don't let me see them at all, because when I'm in retreat, I should not be disturbed normally. But one time, I don't know why, I just venture outside of my protected area, yeah, without letting them know. Normally, I stay inside the gate, about 9 meters distant from, for example, the wall of my cave, okay? 9 meters. And around there, they would tell me to build a little ring of protection. Yeah, about this big, this so wide, and all around, okay? 9 meters around. That day, I don't know why, I walk outside. And when, you know, sometimes I walk outside for fresh air, do walking meditation outside or inside, before I forget. Remind me, the gate, inside. And then normally these the other normal protectors, they can stay long or they can take turn. But the Yosuke goddess, they have to take turn. And they go through different channel. They have to build different channel to come down. They don't go through all this turbulent world, you know, of the lower level, like astral or second level, for example. So they don't have to be affected by this kind of low energy, because they cannot bear. So we build a little channel, and they tunnel, I mean channel or tunnel, whatever they call it, and they come down through that, and they go back through there. So they have nothing to do with any world. That's the safest way. And every 2 days, they have to change guards, because they cannot, even with all the equipment of protection for them, they still cannot stay longer than 2 days. They will not be able to withstand the cause, atmosphere and energy of our planet. Every 2 days, we even have to build new channel, okay? And they come down and build, or they come up and build at the same time, yeah? As they go, they build. Just like if we dive deep into the sea, then we must have the diving suits, yeah, and the oxygen mask and oxygen tank. And they have to have also connection with the boat, ship or something, in case something, okay, they can call for help, okay? Yeah. The same way like that. The EOS goddesses had to protect themselves in different way. And still, just as the divers who dive deep into the ocean, they cannot stay there forever, despite all their equipment. And even the submarine, for example, if you're inside the submarine still need to go up sometimes. Similarly, because they're two different worlds. Our world is very coarse. That's why we have this body, so that we can bear it. Without this body, you cannot. Without this body, you will suffer too much. When the baby comes out of the mother's womb at the time of birth, they suffer too much. It's like thousands of needles are pinching them everywhere. And all the radicals or the elements or whatever in the air, you know, attack them also. Until after a while, then they get used to it. And if any baby has luck to be fed by mother milk, then they have more resistance to the attack of things around us, the elements or the radicals, they call them. Otherwise, they cannot bear it. Their skin is too tender. And they just came from the protected area inside. So they came out and contact with our world, you know, they're so polluted and very contagious and all that. To be born is truly also an agonizing event of our life. That's why the Buddha included birth as one of the four suffering. Yeah? Birth, old age, sickness and death. They're all similar category. Imagine that. Of course, a small little sickness is not counted, okay? Like you have a little runny nose or something, or a little cough, then nowadays we have medicine. And by the way, I tell you again, one of our sisters, she could not eat because whenever she eats, she has some stomach pain. And I say, why didn't you go to doctor? She said, oh, it's just karma. Karma until she became so skinny already. Cannot do that, okay? Maya created karma. But God created doctors and medicine. Use it, for God's sake. I keep telling you since 3 decades already that you have to go to see doctor if you're sick. Just like if some plants are withering near the VIP house, you have to water them. Don't just sit next to it and meditate and think your meditation power will revive the tree. The tree needs different things. The tree needs water and soil and sunshine. This is the way it works in this physical realm. We live in a physical world. We need physical means to take care of physical problem. Sit around a newly planted tree, dry, and just meditate and chanting and singing. This is crazy. You give him water, that's all he needs. He don't care about your meditation, your prayers, nada. Your good heart is appreciated. But water is even more appreciated. You got that?
Yes.
Oh, please, have some common sense. That's not even wisdom, okay? Don't think you're wise if you water the tree. It's ridiculous. That's common sense, okay? Yeah. In the physical world, we use physical means always to take care of physical things. And sometimes when it's really necessary, when it really doesn't work well, then we can pray, of course. Prayer is always necessary, whether or not you use physical means, okay? Always necessary. We need the help of heavens. Yeah, but we, because we're in this physical body, we need to also exert our own power of the mind, the brain, and the physical body. Okay? Don't just always rely on heaven. Heaven cannot help you to drive the car. You are eating it, your food, so heaven don't help you to eat it. So why should heaven help you in other things? Heaven, of course, help you to maybe better digestion, huh? If you pray and you give thanks before you eat, that's the thing to do, okay? To purify your food, that they can do. Invisible help, they give to us, yeah? But physical obligation, physical duty, we have to fulfill, understand?
Yes.
All right, go back to our story, Lord Mahavira's story. The servant used his venomous, you know, gaze to try to burn and kill Lord Mahavira, but it didn't affect him. So maybe he's really, was truly very densely protected by his own purity of aura, yeah, and light, and also maybe heaven's blessing. Oh, I forgot about the story, my story, right? I went to the gate one time, a few months ago. I was meditating on retreat in my cave, yeah? Normally I don't venture out of the gate. I just walk around the cave, you know, wherever there's the clearance. And then that day, I don't know why, I have a phone with me, you know, just in case I need to contact. Normally in retreat I shut off all the phone, yeah? But for security reason, I always keep one because I'm alone, okay, always alone. So I kept one phone and I just walking, and I see some beautiful flowers outside my gate. It was springtime. So I forgot that I am on retreat and I should not venture outside, I forgot. So I open the lock, walk outside. I run out very quickly, you know. Because I see the flowers, I love flowers, I love trees, I love things that are artistic in nature. And then the Hufa, you know, the protectors from Miyosuke, they couldn't react quick enough, so I caught a glimpse of them. I said, who is that? You know, I caught a glimpse of them. I said, who is that? But it's not like I see you, okay? There's a strong presence. Yeah, and split in seconds, it's transparent, almost no visible, and almost no transparent even. So I also was startled, because they were startled, you know, they were scared. Because I walked out so suddenly, yeah, and they did not prepare. Yeah. I was not good. I walk out so quickly, briskly, you know, and then they try to stay away from my path, and I caught a glimpse of them. It's not like you cannot even say that it's so visible, like a transparent sheet of a plastic, nothing like that. But I knew it, and I know it is there, you know, and you can just catch a glimpse. It's like something moving, but nothing. You cannot see an image or anything at all. It's even thinner than transparent. And then I said, who is that? And they said, oh, sorry, your protectors. Oh, I said, oh, I'm sorry too. We both are very sorry. One walked out unexpectedly, and the other one didn't get away quick enough. I said, okay, I just take some photo. You surround me, okay, I'll be back soon. So that was okay. I'm just telling you an example of how the guardian, they don't manifest in a physical form or even transparent form for you to see, because they're not supposed to disturb your concentration. You're not supposed to talk to them or anything. They're as less as possible around you so that you don't have to be attracted to anything. And that's what my experience. So therefore, I knew, even though Lord Mahavira is not visibly protected by heavens, but he must have been. The serpent was now even more astonished. He asked, till today, every man I came across has been consumed by my first venomous hiss, and this man stands still, absolutely unmoved. He probably asked himself, okay, not asking Mahavira, or just talk out loud. The snake don't talk, I guess. Do they? No. Maybe he talked in his heart. So the serpent glanced at the sun and once again focused his gaze at Mahavira and hissed at him with renewed anger, but in vain. Why did he look at the sun? Anybody know? Recharging, wow, how you know that? You have been serpent in your last life? Cool, that's what I think also, eh? Yeah, well, the people recharge themselves from the sun also. We call them solarian, because they eat from the sun energy. They gaze at the sun 10 minutes in the morning when the sun rises, and 10 minutes in the evening before the sunset to recharge themselves. Don't do it. And don't blame me if you become skeleton, no? Don't try too hard, okay? Eat your normal meal, just don't eat too much, so that you can meditate, Not that all the wisdom go to your stomach and you have empty head. So the snake slithers from the line of the expected fall of the body, and then with all its force sank its fangs in Mahavira's toe and injected all his venom. Oh, God. He looked at him, thinking that he might fall, okay? I didn't fall. So he went all that way and sank his fangs into the toe of the master, yeah. The snake then drew back and waited expectantly again, in vain. Oh, my God. What kind of man is he, this man? Lord Mahavira, I told you I never see such a resistance like this. It must be made of iron, huh? Don't try, huh? Don't try to see what you're made of, huh? I'm sure you know already, right? The angry serpent, vexed further by its failure, stung Mahavira thrice again. All its three attacks were wasted. Nothing worked. So Mahavira stood undisturbed. The serpent was astonished to see only milk oozing out from his wounds instead of blood where it had stung Mahavira's toe. Lord Mahavira's Swami was standing unmoved still. So his face was glowing and on his lips was a charming smile. I don't know if I can smile in that case. Hey, this guy is Superman. Not to talk about Lord or not. Superman. Like a blooming rose, his smile was. His eyes reflected the inner compassion. The serpent continued to stare with surprise. Confused by its failure, it was lost in its thoughts. Involved in his spiritual pursuits, Mahavira uttered in his deep and tranquil voice, "Oh, Chandrakaushik, open your inner eyes." Chandrakaushik, maybe it's the name of the snake or the type of the snake. I guess this is the way you address this type of snake in a former time. He said to the snake, "Okay, let's make it more simple. Oh, snake." Okay. That's probably what he said, with all his love and charm. Involved in his spiritual pursuits, Mahavira uttered in his deep and tranquil voice, "Oh, Chandrakaushik, open your inner eyes." Chandrakaushik, maybe it's the name of the snake or the type of the snake. I guess this is the way you address this type of snake in a former time. He said to the snake, "Okay, let's make it more simple. Oh, snake." Okay. That's probably what he said, with all his love and charming smile. "Open your inner eyes, yes. Be calm and remember your past life." Maybe that's his name in the past life. So the master knows the past life and remind him of that. So, "Do not inject venom of anger in your life. Rise above the deadly poison of anger." And then Mahavira opened his ambrosia-filled eyes, full of sweet nectar, or the eyes filled with love. So when the serpent met his gaze, it felt as if a wave of peace and tranquility had engulfed its inner self. Please don't try. Don't try. See if your eyes has enough power to melt the serpent's heart or not. Okay? Or any other vicious animals. They do understand. They do understand. But I'm not sure at that time if they want to show you their understanding or not when you gaze at them, okay? The best when you see any beast, okay? Any wild beast, don't stare at their eyes. That means war. That means provocation. That means challenging, okay? That means you want to show your toughness and to fight, see who is better, who is the boss. Don't ever, okay? If you see wild animal, if you cannot run, then just lower your head. No, really. Recite the five names, say, "Father in heaven, glory by your name," and etc. If you lower your head, the animals may feel less challenged, less threatened. Maybe they will not attack you. Don't look at the animals' eyes, except your dogs and your pet, your tamed animals. This is just a body language. The animals, they have their body language. There are many different gestures they do for different type of animals. Horses, they have the different type of body language. Dogs, they have different type of body language. Cats, you know, leopard, lion, and tigers, etc., etc. They all have their body languages. You cannot learn forever. So maybe you have learned to master dog's body language, and if you use it on tiger, I don't know if it works. Don't mix up the language, okay? Maybe the tiger doesn't know another foreign language, then you'll be in trouble. Dogs also understand humans' language. It's easy for them. Most animals, they know languages by the way you speak out or when you think in your head. Like, for example, if you think about a book, then in your mind, in your aura, in your magnetic field, will appear a book. Then the dog understand that it's a book. I did not have to tell my dog, I'm going to get the veggie bone for you. I just think. They know immediately. And they follow me with wagging tail and drooling, waiting. If you have your loving energy and intention in your mind, when you just incidentally meet a wild animal, then it could be helpful. But I don't know how much, okay? Because I don't know how much loving quality you have within you at that time. Maybe they can just smell your fear, and that's the worst thing that can happen to you. When the animals smell your fear, that means you're finito, kaput. Yeah. So always remember, okay? Practice love and compassion daily in your thought, your speech, and your action. So that in time of danger, you still have that with you. And then that may be your savior, except your master, yeah. But if your time is up, then don't worry, okay? You always pray every day, meditate, so that you can go to Nirvana, no? Or new land, no? Then at that time, just remember master. Or maybe you couldn't even remember the master, then the master has to remember you. That would be the best. Lucky, huh? There was a joke, I don't know if I told you already, because this story is all very, very, very serious and scary, so I have to put some funny calendar in between, okay? There's a joke. One man went to a deep jungle, you know, deep, deep, very unheard of jungle. No man from our society, civilization ever walked in there. There's a tribe, they live together, okay? So he went there, you know, for some purpose. I don't know what, maybe just curious, maybe to get some medicine, maybe whatever. Visit. Yeah, some people like to walk into wilderness anywhere just to see something new. Because they're fed up with city jungle, you know, with high buildings and traffic and people. So he went to very remote, very, very remote corner of the planet, remote place of deep jungle. And suddenly he saw a group of big people, painted face and enlarged earlobe and extended fangs and with a spear in their hands and jumping and shouting very loud, surrounding him. So he has never believed in God his whole life, or don't practice any Kuan Yin method, nada. So at that time he remembered God for the first time ever. So I said, oh God, I'm sorry, I have never remembered you. I have been too busy, but please help me if you really exist. Tell me what to do. So God said, okay, I exist and I will help you. So the man, you know, trembling, said, what can I do now? He said, am I going to die here, oh Lord? He said, no, your time is not up yet. You know the story, yeah? I told some time before. So the man was very happy, you know, oh, wonderful. I'm not going to die yet, you know, my time's not up. So what to do, Lord? So the Lord said, you snatch the spear from the man with the biggest feather head next to you. Snatch it to your hand. So he did that. And then the man snatched and has a spear in his hand and asked the Lord, what next now, my Lord? So the Lord said, now your time is up. Even 1 second, you cannot die early. You see that? So don't worry, if you die, you die. Even God cannot help you. Oh, he does help, but in his own way, you know. There's another story similar. I think you know it, but maybe not. There was a man who was falling from the cliff, and then suddenly, midway, he got hold of a branch of the tree. And he also never believed in God before, but in this situation, he suddenly remembered the poor man, old man up there. He said, oh God, please help me. Even though I didn't pray to you ever, but please, if you exist, make me believe that you exist. Help me now. So God said, okay, of course, of course. Let go of the branch, and I will help you. And the man said, anybody else? Anybody else there? Yeah, that's how much you believe in God. Always say, oh, I believe God, I believe. Whatever God say, I'll do it. In this situation, no. Yeah, it's only one test and he failed. Yeah, be careful. Mostly you are being tested, but you don't even know, okay? So that you can maybe go higher, next level. So be always prepared. Be always prepared and really have belief in God. Or faith in your master or your path or your practice and all the things that are good. Okay? Believe it. Practice it so that you always are ready. So even if you die the last moment, you know your life has been worthwhile. And that you have no regret in your heart. You're ready to go to a higher dimension. Dimension or dimension? Both are okay. English sometimes confuse me. Infinite, infinite, I don't even know where the finite is. Where we find the night. Just like the man go to Hawaii, a German guy asked the man who looked like a native, is this island called Hawaii or Hawaii? Because in our country, German, they pronounce W like a V, you know, like, you're welcome. So he say, is the island here called Hawaii or Hawaii? So the man said, Hawaii. So look like native man said, Hawaii. And then the German said, oh, that's what I thought, thank you. Because everybody told me it's Hawaii, so thank you. I know now it's Hawaii. Thank you very much. So the man said, you're welcome. And now you know, right? I thought about one joke, but I think it's going to be on TV, so I don't tell you. Okay. When the serpent's eyes met the gaze of Lord Mahavira, it felt as if a wave of peace and tranquility has engulfed its inner self. See, affect the being inside, not the outside. Outside it just surface. Anything affect you inside, touch you, make you believe. That is the real thing. Anything outside, sometimes it looks like good, but it's not good. Sometimes it may look bad, but it's not really bad. Okay? Because our physical eyes deluded us many times. Same with our physical ears. Also make us trouble, and we can hear wrong a lot of time. Therefore, we don't use the physical eyes, we don't use physical ears, we don't use any physical means to meditate. Everything from inside is the real thing, the best, and permanent, lasting. Thank God we have a lot of time for my calendar, because you're not going to eat or anything now, right? Okay. It appeared that its venom was slowly vanishing. Yeah, even he lost his venom slowly, yeah. So the snake was lost in deep thoughts. Its dormant memory started unfolding, and it acquired Chatismaran Chanan, some kind of maybe the power to remember past life, yeah? Incidents from its past two births surfaced in its memory. He remembered two births, two last births. Not everyone or not every being, even saints and sages, remember long lives past. Some remember more, some remember less. Some animals remember their past lives, yes. My dogs, they do. Yeah. Like, for example, the dogs who speak English, she knows she was hermit last life. But she always run away from me. And after I had her baby, then she come knocking at the door. One day she came in and knocked at the door, want to come in. Before that, she run away so quick. So after we already friends, you know, family, I asked her, why did you run away from me if you were hermit? Do you remember your hermit? She said, yes. And then why did you run away from me? We were friends before. She said, because you forbid us to come back to this life. That's why. I did not forbid. I said, don't come back here again. is a place of suffering. I don't want you to suffer anymore. So from now on, don't run away from me, okay? She said, no, now I don't want to. Yeah. They all remember their past life. Sometimes they change their physical form, you know? So you cannot always recognize your dog. But another dog, for example, you know, a female dog, she is very similar to the last life because her tail is very bushy and curling up, you know? And whenever she see me, she lay on her back with all four upwards. The same like last life. Not all the dogs do that. Maybe they turn one leg up so I can see their stomach to rub, 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 you know, they like that. But not her. She make all four up. Exactly the same. And if I call her by her name, her pet name, last lifetime, and she says, very happy, happy, happy. Sometimes I call them last names. Just sometimes. Like I don't want to always remind them of, you know, their last life when they had some suffering before they die or something like that. But for dogs, most animals, it's quick. Okay, they don't suffer long. It lasts 1 hour, 2 hours of suffering, then they go. Nowadays we have medicine to lessen their pain. It's also thank God for that. Now, the serpent realized that it had suffered excruciating pain and degradation due to extreme anger and acute attachment during those last two births. The heat of repentance melted its vices. He repents so much, so that all his vices mean anger, gone. Its spirit embraced enlightenment and its mind became tranquil. It touched the pious feet of Lord Mahavira Swami and resolved, O Lord, now I will not look at anyone at all throughout my life. He decided, he repented his bad deeds and he said he will never look anyone anymore. Because he knows if you look at them, they finished. They burn and die. I will not eat anything. He continued to repent and vow in front of Lord Mahavira, say he won't eat anything. I will also not drink anymore. I will just put my mouth in the hole and lie still in the shadow of your feet. I will now at once, for all my sins committed during the last three births, and improve my future. For what I guess is that Lord Mahavira has paid off whatever karma he had to pay, yeah, while interacting with all beings on this planet, all his life, afterlife, reincarnation. So maybe he has more power now. Thus, even the snake's poisonous gaze doesn't affect him, and the poisonous bite did not kill him or injure him. Now, knowing that the serpent had become harmless, throngs of people started arriving from nearby villages. They worshipped the serpent god. Yeah, he's a kind of a god, eh? Yeah. Serpent god, or maybe serpent demon, or serpent god. They worship him by offering milk and sweets. God, it's another non-common sense people. How can the snake eat any sweet? Huh? Chocolate? Maybe. But the serpent was laying still, keeping its hood in the hole, in meditation, without even a trace of movement. Swarms of ants were attracted by the sweets. Oh, poor man, God. See that? They started stinging the serpent, but the serpent tolerates these afflictions with equanimity. And stupidity does hurt, yeah? You see, they put sweet around him, so all the ants come. And by the way, they also bite the serpents because this, the sweat probably drop off on his body. And the ant also bite his body. See that? They say the road to hell is paved with good intention. So don't be idiotly good. Be smartly good. My God, how much longer I have to talk? Must have common sense. No need even wisdom. The snake don't ever eat sweet to start with, right? But the Indian people, they love sweet. They make sweet that is sweeter than sugar. You believe that? You know, right?
Yes, Master.
Yeah. And they call them what? I forgot.
Barfi.
Okay. Oh, this white stuff. They mix condensed sweet milk with sugar and some other sweet things and mix with the all the stuff. Imagine. It's sweeter than sweet. Just eat one enough to gain 2 kilograms. And there's also like ladu, right? Ladu. And already sweetened, you know, like a sweet bowl. Brown is soaked in syrup. Yeah, it's already sweet bowl and then it soaks in condensed syrup. Oh, my God. Yeah, I don't know why they love sweets so much. But I know they are very sweet people. Maybe that's why. Don't try and blame me. So if you put sweet anywhere, then the ants will come. Of course, yeah. So unintentionally, the villagers harm the snakes instead of helping. You know, milk, you know, and sweet sprinkle around him and surround him. Of course, they're going to, you know, bite him everywhere on his body. So now the snake, even with all these pains and afflictions, the snakes bore it all with equanimity. It silently took the last vow. The last vow meaning the vow you make before you die. Okay? Any vow you make before you die, they think is very efficient and very powerful. Okay? So the snake took the last vow before it died. Meaning, fast to death. In old time, Indian people has this tradition. If they feel like they have done enough or they're old already and they want to die, then they fast until they go. In Alaska, before also, the Eskimo people, I don't know if they make a vow or not, but when they're older and no use anymore to the family and become frail and feeble, then they also don't eat anything. They went out to the field, the icy field, and sat there until they die. In the old time, the Eskimo people, when will they go? When all their teeth are gone. Because if without the teeth, they have no more means to chew the leather of the animals to make clothing or bedding or any instrument that they need to use in their life. In those times, Alaska wasn't Alaska today. The Eskimo people, they live in this, I forgot what they call that, the ice cave? Huh? Igloo. Yeah, igloo. They chop ice into block, square block, and then they build it together so to make an igloo. Surprising, you live inside. It's warmer than outside. You live in the ice cave, but it's warmer than outside. And inside they even put fire. And it don't melt the ice. Yeah, there's some corner of the world you don't know. You don't know how lucky you are living in Taiwan or China, Vietnam, Korea. Huh? And nowadays even more lucky. Nowadays any poor person is luckier than the king. Normally poor, not too poor, but normally poor, luckier, more comfortable than the king in old time, yeah? Because you can go on the bus, yeah? Or you have a fifth-hand car or something, and you can have a window with glass, huh? before the king palace, window or door is plastered with blurry kind of paper. You know, nowadays the Japanese still make door from that. He see nothing outside, nothing. And if he has to go somewhere, I take him, oh, I don't know, depends on where he go. Maybe days or weeks or months on the horse carriage, which is go kaboom, kaboom, kaboom. And the sore, royal butt, yeah? For days or weeks or months on end. Even the royal butt still has to be sore because it's the condition of a horse carriage. Even he has the best horses, still, and thicker cushion and all that. Still his body, his bone, his royal body, butt and bone also shaking together with the horse galloping. So nowadays we are really, really comfortable. We have to thank all the masters who brought blessing to our planet. Thanks all the sacrifices of past, present, master and practitioners. Thanks all the heavens, together with human saints and good human that form a field of blessing for us to enjoy. Heavens can bless, but we human must also do something according to situation, according to our job, according to our mission. Don't just rely on heaven. We must also help heaven to bless our world, and then we also profit because we live here. If the atmosphere, the energy is good around us, then we also feel good. So to bless our world, we have to work with heaven by our physical means, by meditating, by doing good, by helping each other, and by thanking God also, and praying for the best of all beings on this planet, and meditate. Now, this next body became almost perforated. But it did not react at all. After 15 days, the snake died and was reborn as a god in the Sahasra dimension. Wow. Sitting next to an enlightened saint. Yeah, borrow also his blessing. But it's not only the saint. Saint can bless you. You also must be good. The serpent has become good and purifying himself by his sincere repentance and endurance of the suffering to repay all the karma that he made, the bad karma. So he was reborn as the god. Imagine, no matter what god, he's still better than the snake. Okay, the end of the story. Next time, huh? Any question?
初次宇宙的是第十届师父说的哈，那师父做的星落度在几届呀？啊，第十亿，第十二就是伊奥斯克了。嗯，我知道。还有问题？我在这里只是想分享那天。 我所看到的，因为太震撼了，我就印心，就是这样震撼的事情是三次嘛，第三次，就是那天，哎，哦，满空都是祝福菩萨赞叹师父，啊，然后师父就很高兴的、很自然的唱那个《我永远爱你》，嗯，就唱歌的时候，嗯，
你是说在天空的。
无形的声音，只有你听到而已，是吗？师父的声音简直就是震动宇宙，整个地球也在那个颤抖，然后耳朵都震得到很那个，我就很震撼，很震撼。嗯，然后我当时就高兴的只是在那个就是享受那个境界嘛。嗯，然后我就回去之后我就。 闭关七天，我当时是只享受那个高兴的事情的。但是闭关七天的时候，我更震撼的事情是，因为师父高兴唱歌的时候，那个震动的那个力量，就把那很多魔王的宫殿给毁掉了，他们就瓦解了。
嗯。
我就太高兴，那边七天闭关之后，哇，师父高兴一次，对宇宙这个震动的这个力量太震撼人了，就那个声音就耳朵我都起吹气，或几天听不见，旁边的我家师兄跟我说什么，我说你说什么我听不清楚，这耳朵都震的。
了解。
嗯，然后就是我七天闭关之后，我去看我二姐，然后我二姐见我说，哎，那天师父唱歌的时候啊，那声音好震撼，好震撼，好那个高的地方都能震动震动的。我说你也听到了，我说他看到了一个很强的光和还有那个听到师父的那个唱歌的那个声音，震动宇宙的那个。我说我俩都是同感呐，我说我们真幸运，真有福报，能听到师父唱歌的时候那种。频率好好高好高，不知道多高，我不知道，可能是无边。还有第二天父亲节，师父拿了那个乐器，曼陀罗。
曼陀林。
对对对对，师父唱这样琴的时候，那时候的那个震动频率和唱歌又不一样。它是像那个湖面的那个圆形的那种波。一会儿是七彩光，一会儿是九彩光。又是震动宇宙，全满宫都是佛菩萨、天神、天女，还有童子都在合掌，都一起唱歌。然后那两天都是下的那个光点的那个雨，全是那个花，全是光的花，而且那个这我们这个整个道场都是七种那种香气，我没办法用语言来表示。
了解。
而那天。我就这个人就好像魂儿没有一样，自己控制不了自己的腿。然后结束之后，我们几位这一起来的那个同修就看，佛菩萨都不愿意离去，一直加持我们，那香气一直在这扑突扑扑过来，我们哭着抱着。我说我们师父高兴一次，怎么这么没办法形容？太震撼，而且那个全宇宙的那些佛菩萨。都在赞叹师父的那种力量。然后我回去七天闭关之后，我就是打开无意看那个新闻，一看，哎呦，中国中央电视台播吃素环保救地球，
可能吗？
还有救动物，
有没有录起来给我们看？
那个我手机才能查出来，我这手机现在网络不行。
OK。
然后中央电视台播了之后，我想，
哇哦，谢谢中国。
师父做什么事情必须有那个物质的有形的接应一下子，
当然
才可以消化
无形跟有形在一起。
对对对，这内在的
天地
合一，是师父就内在的师父就这样告诉我。
哎，谢谢中央政府了。
对，
谢谢大陆的政府。
他们还提倡要保护动物，因为动物也是有生命的。
好，不得了
啊，这个影响力太大了。
了解。
对对，
中国现在是带领力量很大嘛。好，你说。
刚才我讲的是第三次，第二次的时候也是我打坐闭关一个月之后，内在的师父说你去那个中国的西藏佛学院，有一个大型法会，很大的一个法会，参加的世界各地的出家人，不管是尼姑尼姑喇嘛，还有一般的在家人，我不知道是。为什么让我去？我不知道，让我去我就去了。
去，
然后那
天拥护他们呢？
来的那些喇嘛和全部的人，差不多有40万到50万。然后我就被那一种力量把我那个推到那个法殿里边去。然后很多那个尼姑的喇嘛在那边念经，然后我就在那里念五句，念七戒礼物。然后我就。大脑不知道自己在说什么，但是内在的就跟宇宙沟通，然后一下子师父就在空中，很多佛空中中间师父站的很高很高的一个很庄严的形象出现，然后我就哭的眼泪鼻涕都流下来，
谁出现？
师父的形象
啊。
就声音就是师父的声音，但是我看不到师父，因为我太小了。 师父太高大了，我就好不容易爬到师父的脚趾甲上面，就拇指甲上面爬上去、
那个、
我说亲爱的师父、
那个、
我看不到师父的脸，
那个不是眼角啊，眼角更高啊，
然后我说我看不到师父脸怎么办，师父一下子就把我送到跟师父到这里来，我就能看到师父的脸、
到胸部来就看到了、
看到师父脸，但是就是佛那个寺庙里边的那个佛的形象，脸就是师父的脸。
嗯，
那天也是很多喇嘛都在看了，我们快下山的时候
他们也看得到啊，
他们也看得到，我们下山的时候他们最那个顶级的喇嘛就是院长，他就在那个五层楼最里面中间那边嘛，下山之后他们才找我们，那些几个人
找谁？找你们？
找我们，我们几个人是不是可能认识那个师兄啊
OK
啊，他们领着我们去的。
嗯，
然后就我们走了之后他们才一切那个享受完之后找我们，他们是干什么的？
他怎么知道是你们造成的？
因为我们去念五句又念七戒礼物，然后就出现那样的形象嘛。
他们怎么知道你们念五句呢？
他们是天眼都开的、
对对，了解了解。
我们一念他就光就出来嘛。
有一届有神通当然
对对对，
忘记忘记。
他们那个院长都是这个是开的、然后就找我们。
嗯，
就那时候是第二次的震撼。
嗯。哇、哦！
我还有第一次的震撼是我刚印心，然后就师父让我闭关，我就闭谷，然后不说话两年多，
嗯，
然后我就不想出定了。师父说你光闭关打坐不行啊，这样的活不要了，你称佛都没有用，你赶紧出去干活，就这样。我说我不用干活，那好，你就不干吧。然后我就没钱嘛，没办法。然后我说我去，到底去哪里嘛？然后师父说，你去韩国永东道场，就这样。我说我到那里做什么呀？说你到那里闭关一个月，好好照顾他们，就这样。我说，那我是一个在家人，怎么照顾出家人呢？
啊，
我就没办法，大脑没办法想象。那天我打坐的时候，师父出现。师父好高大，好高大，
又来了
又来了。然后那是第一次嘛，然后就我就一看师父很庄严，很庄严。一看师父的脚，两双脚都是没穿鞋，佛很庄严，很庄严，很华丽，光都很强。就一看脚出脓血，脚上面出脓和血。
流血啊！
流血，然后我就心疼的不得了，我就处理都干净了。
嗯，
然后师父说，你考验通过，你去照顾他们。然后我就去了韩国，我到那里没找工作，我先去闭关嘛。
嗯，
然后就已经那边出家人还有常住已经都离开了，差不多离开了。
嗯，
我就一大早早上给他们做饭，白天打坐。
嗯，
然后。那个下午那个菜地里边奶菜，晚饭早饭就这样给他们供养，做饭一起打坐。我说你们一定会有好事的，我不能说什么，我只能说你们都回来吧，跟我一起打坐吧，这是上帝的意思，我只能这么说。然后一个月之后已经往生的那个菩萨，那个他是第一去五戒师父公布的那位菩萨已经往生了嘛，他来了以后公布不退菩萨。
嗯，
然后这些出家人高兴啊，然后我们又抱着哭啊。
嗯，
哎呀师姐呀，你好不容易把我们留在这里，结果师父就已经供布我们是不对菩萨。那时候我所看到的师父的形象也是就三次，就是这么很震撼的。但是我用语言现在就没办法就是表达那种场面，
知道
那时候的境界。
知道，
我就知道我怎么那么有福报。
嗯，你打坐多吗？
我就再次感谢师父。
我也感谢你。嗯，那么诚心，
非常非常感谢，
有话很多，很用功。嗯，很诚心，我也感谢你。
谢谢师父，
常来，
很认真的。
然后有机会去别国 ，OK？
好的，嗯，好。
有钱吗？
有。有
，OK，
我自己有。
一说要去哪里，万一不够钱就，我会付给你，好吗？
不会，师傅，那个钱用在别的地方，我自己有。
OK, very good. 还有什么震撼吗？
还有一个是就是那个上回禅期圣诞节禅期师父旁边坐了一位穿黄色的和尚，是不是记得？
呀呀呀，
他是我弟弟。
你的弟弟呀？
对，亲弟弟。
真的是弟弟或是受养的？
亲弟弟
啊，
他是老六。亲弟弟、啊、我是第三。
老三啊，第三。 OK OK OK老三
啊，然后上回师父说让他传法，然后宣传他的信徒吃素嘛。
嗯。
然后他当时答应了。
嗯。
然后现在很不错，信他的人都跟他一起吃素，然后又辟谷。
嗯。
然后他说将来这些人都会拉到这里来一心。
嗯 ，OK OK。
然后他说感谢师父，里边教导很多。
好好，
他就转过一下子。太感恩师父。
好的，老和尚。
就这些。谢谢师父。
老六的和尚。OK。他坐得很挺啊，坐得不动啊，不错。
他白天12个小时太阳下观光，然后晚上就是观音。我说你那睡不睡？他说需要睡吗？他就这样反问，我就没办法再说了。他很精进的。
嗯。
他说我不打坐，那对不起师父。
嗯。
既然一心了，要好好打坐。
嗯。
分担一些这个宇宙的业障。嗯，
你们几个老不错。
惭愧师父。
那老一老二在哪里呢？那两个老的中间那个老在哪里？
那个他们本来要来，但是身体不太好。
OK OK。
没来的。
OK 了解。 okay,
下次有机会
赶快养好然后再来。
好，谢谢师父。嗯，谢
谢。我很高兴见到你。嗯，
见
到你几个老。嗯。然后那个老和尚也要带来。
好的。嗯，谢谢。
他修得好 好，你们全家都 OK， 我谢谢你们。嗯，真的谢
谢。嗯，
有这种徒弟我也觉得时间值得。嗯。
谢谢。
OK,Thank you, really, 多谢。真的是这样，那个小老过来，哭什么？yeah. 要问问你的那个大佬 ，OK？ 三老那个，老三那个，不客气啊， yeah. 保重啊，嗯，自信不要太高啊，随时都要祷告 ，OK？ 呀，嗯。还有什么震撼的事吗？啊？哇，莱蒙志，太好了！哎，你说
好消息啊
！OK，
是在大陆嘛，我小孩两个，一个高中，一个小学。那学校就应教育部的要求嘛，学校给孩子们全校开那种动员大会，就鼓励孩子们多吃素。讲这个素食对环境有多重要，两个小孩回来都有跟我说，妈妈，因为他们两个也有一心，我们学校有正式公开讲这个概念，啊，对，然后同学他们同学有的不太接受，两个小孩还帮忙去讲，说这个很重要，真的对我们环境很重要，就是他教育局教育部有下达这种指令，就每个学校都会给孩子们。就强调这件事情。
对他们很健康呢。
对对对，
小病呢，对国家不用花那么多钱。
对对对，
治病啊，
就有强调很清楚，这个对地球很重要。哎，给小孩子讲的。
哦，太好了。如果有机会的话，孟师傅，谢谢政府。
哎，好的好的。
大陆的政府，我非常感恩。
好的好的，谢谢师傅。
哎，不是就地球而已，哦。养小孩健康，嗯，因为如果小孩啊或是人民健康的话，国家省哇
省
千万亿钱呐、啊，
是是是，
因为任何国家就生病啊，那个保险生病的最多钱的，
是是，
都是因为吃肉，
是
吃肉吃鱼喝酒
是
吸烟那些吸毒那些都是。 伤害国家的那个功库太大了。
是是，
那种钱省下来可以帮助贫穷的国民，还有可以帮助外国的那个众生啊，还有动物啊，
对，
国外的那个公民啊，哎呀，所以我非常感激你们的政府，
谢谢，
我非常高兴，
谢谢，
我今天回去会祷替他们祷告，
谢谢师父，谢谢师父，谢谢。
台湾没那么大，呵呵，不过很多人是说，谢谢佛教那个教理，谢谢道教的教理，谢谢一贯道啊，还有某些天主教的部分啊，天主教有一些宗派是吃素的，我谢谢他们啊，大家好，嗯。呵呵，我没想到大陆政府这么好，连中央的电视台也播放吃素环保救地球，真的吗？经常常常播放啊，我也会替他们祷告我会分享一些我的福报给他们，给你们政府跟中央电视台，嗯，你要说什么？
地铁里面都有那个明星，然后说劝大家吃素食的广告。
哦，
嗯，然后特别
明星也起来了。
对对对，
也出来讲了。
嗯，
啊，救动物了。
不穿动物衣服的广告。
不穿动物的衣服，哇！
对对，他们明星都这样。
明星也站起来了。
对对，
啊，太好了。
火车站、地铁都有这种广告。
哎呀，你们国家时间到了。
变化，最近变化特别快。特别大，到处都能看到。
人家拍手，我听不到。急什么你啊？说，
我太兴奋了，因为就是师父闭关结束之后啊，这就是明显的每天宣传的特别多，然后就有那个动物协会啊，揽那个狗狗，他们吃狗狗肉嘛，在、广东那边吃的特别多，
然后
他们就把那些车全部拦下来，
嗯，
然后公安局出动，一起把那些狗都救出来，
哦，
然后救济到那边去，然后大家那个不死钱，把那些狗啊、就能带，个人想带的
就能带，多少就
多少，对，先带不去的先分配到那个救济站那边养他们一会儿，然后就网上一直
做。政府拥护的吗？
是公安局政府的，
公安局那是政府的吗？
对，就是政府。
Oh my god！
然后就
谢谢
拿那个布施的钱暂时给他们狗狗吃的粮啊什么的，然后就有那个药的主人他们在网上广告，
嗯，
然后看到那个我们就随时都可以想领养。
哦，
他做到现在特别好，在当年，
没想到，
是的，
啊，当然也想到了，不过也是我也很震撼，
都是师父的加持，
啊、
太明显了，
谢谢相
近，最近这，嗯、太明显，
啊，谢谢，
很多地方好几次都这样，
谢谢天堂，
我在这几天在那个网上，在新疆那边有一次，广东那边三次，就是揽这个。狗狗很大的卡车里面满满的三层狗，三层啊，它那个笼子里面三层的狗都给救出来了，
哦，
25名、会员，就是爱保护动物的那种会员，还有警察16名出动，
哦，
就这样把他们揽下来，这样救过来了，
非常，
我们都
非常好，谢谢大陆，
很感动大陆现在政府也重视这个吃素方面，
我还会继续打坐了，我能闭关没事多久天
了，然后国家习主席也说了，
哎，
要这个有信仰，
嗯，
但是我们中国大部分的百姓都是信佛嘛，也是几千年的历史嘛，所以就国家开始提倡有一个信仰，然后道德精神文明，然后环保意识
啊，
现在中国也是把这个垃圾分类，现在已经有这个下文了，我们就把全部的垃圾都给分类，以前不分类的乱七八糟都一起丢，现在全部要分类的，要不分类罚款，但喜欢钱的人不想分类也得分，很好的，现在太好了，
你长也越来越好看，嗯，
谢谢师父。
好庄严。
我比上回好一点，因为上回我来的时候业障比较多。然后自己带的药，家里出发之前有预感嘛。我就吃完，然后在这里领药也不好使，然后我就祈求上帝，我去再去吃药。还好
，OK 了哈。
然后我就体验到那么好的
，OK 了哈。
太感恩了。一定要这个物质的药和里面祈求上帝要配合。我刚才是不是讲到说我是真体验到那个？
是啊。
不能小看这个物质的方法科技。
对了对了对了，印度的医生哈，我有时候偶然呢、啊。碰到印度的医生，一些有信仰的医生哈，他们都写在他们那个诊所里面了，是吧？我是开药单，不过是你是医病的，这样子啊。I prescribe, but you heal。他说上帝治病的，是他写药单而已。他抓药了，不过上帝。会帮忙治病，
明白意思。上帝通过这个工具，
对，
然后治病
啊，还是需要药了。
对，是需要。
不过也是有加持力啊，天然加持，天地合一，合作
是
才有用。
是
比较有用啊，
是
都是靠天堂而已，也不够。
是，
当然恳求的时候没有别的办法，没有物质的办法的话，天堂也会尽量。
恳求的时候，有时候师父就随便控制我的手机。大神师父，就是今年的师父生日那天，师父生日、佛诞日、母亲节都是同一天吗？然后我就是前一天在地里，在阳光下打坐，然后我们就跟我们那个共修结束说，我说明天是重要日子啊，你们都要来的，然后他们没有意识到说不来。然后我说。怎么不来呢？你们不知道明天什么日子啊？我就这样想，那算了吧，我就不说了，看要看你们的悟性了。然后早晨我一般打坐，晚上9点开始打坐的话，6点半才结束。但那天5点就手机里边突然那个纳鲁巴找那个迪洛巴师傅的，然后就纳鲁巴用自己的肉身做那个曼多罗供养师傅嘛。师傅就。讲经那个手机里面声音好大，整个屋里都是震的。然后我叫师傅说，你怎么睡觉半夜开师傅的讲经这么大呢？邻居家吵醒了。我说不是我的，是你的手机吧？他说是你的。然后我就找手机，不知道哪里播，找了半天，在音乐里面自动播放。然后我就想起来，我昨天还没有买加持物啊。然后我就赶紧去那个超市。超市那时候不开门，但有一家水果店，全部是新鲜的。然后我就买了那个新鲜的好多种。那个师姐一起去了，她说她要付款，那好吧，那你就给你一个机会吧。我知道师父说供养师父那个花的话，新鲜的花这也是一种生命嘛，师父就不喜欢。我就心里想，
那用盆子花，
他那个。那个时间点没有卖那个
啊，没有卖，
都是已经剪好的
了。了解了解。
因为他是5点嘛。然后我就去了之后啊，那个时间要买花啊，买水果，然后那一代师傅说，你去买花吧，他已经买的水果，你去买花吧，让我去买花。买完以后回来，我就告诉了另一个说昨天不来的师姐，我说那你也买吧，而那个师姐非得他也要买。那两朵就不太好了，两这么大的一个花篮，然后以后那天就着急嘛，又来电话，他们要来不来什么乱七八糟的，我就忘记了供养一个新鲜的水，然后师父说，嘿，你犯错误了，赶紧去拿新鲜的水供养哦，你点蜡烛了，香都有了，水还没有呢，我说要赶紧跑下去拿水。就那样，那天又是一个活菩萨加持，然后在家里很隆重的一个师父的生日，又是佛诞节，又是母亲节，很感恩师父提醒。
哎呀，我不记得什么时候，
真忘记了。这样的神奇的事情经常发生。
就没什么。
我是一个就是机器人，脑子也不会动。 里面上帝让我做什么我就做什么。
好，
就是空白一个，
应该这样子，
傻傻的，别人说我傻。
Thank you， 谢谢你的故事。这边就有两个老，还有啊，那个小老也要呢。
韩国也有好消息。这个礼拜我来之前，那个韩国有个传统嘛，三伏吃那个狗肉。三伏，初伏、中伏，还有三伏，最热的时候。就是意思是那个夏天最热的时候他们吃狗肉补养身体，就这个传统。完了我们同修都去了，去了那个铁姑他是最后一个那个什么狗肉市场了。完了他们在那儿那个什么都那个什么抗议，完了最后把那个也给撤了。现在韩国没有那个什么狗市场了。
厉害厉害，再来再来哈。谢谢老肖。老五。我觉得奇怪，他什么是老虎呢？我认为是生成日子。我认为是生下来是老虎的年。我说连这个也跟我讲，干什么？好了。